So now we will discuss about min terms and max terms. So min terms, these are the standard product terms. These min terms and max terms are used to grab the expression from the truth table. We have a truth table and we need to grab an expression, boolean expression from that table in order to realize that function or that circuit. So let us suppose we have function of variables, three variables a, b and c, and it is defined as ab plus a bar bc. So here this function is not in standard product form. Why? Because this is a min term, but this is not a min term. Why? For a min term, the total number of variables involved in the function should be present in that term. Here we have all the three variables, but here we have not c, so this is not a min term, this is a min term. Now let us see again as f abc as abc plus a bar b bar c plus a bar b c bar. So here the total number of variables is abc. So here a, b, c, all three are present. Here also all three variables are present. Here also all three variables are present. So these all are min terms. This is a min term, this is a min term, and this is also a min term. So this is a standard product form. This was not a standard product form. This is a standard product form. Let us see this table. So for min terms, what we will see, this min term would be represented as a0, b0, c0. How we will represent this as a bar, b bar, c bar. This min term as a bar, b bar, c. This min term as a bar, b, c bar. This min term as a bar, b, c. A is 1, so a, b 0, b bar, c 0, c bar. A, b bar, c bar. This one as a, b bar, c. A, b, c bar. A, b, c. This is min term 0. This is min term 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on up to 7. Why this is 0 and why this is 7? Because these, if you take this as a binary number, then its decimal conversion is 0. The decimal conversion of this, decimal equivalent of this binary number is 7. The decimal equivalent of this binary number is 4. So this is min term 4. Number of variables in this case is 3, abc. Total number of midterms would be, total number of midterms we can see is 8, and 8 can be represented as 2 to the power 3. Hence for n variables, total number of midterms will be 2 to the power n. Note, midterms lead to sum of product expression. How? Let's see. Suppose we have this function as it is 1 for 0 0 and also 1 for 1 0. Now we will see where the function is 1 and write the expression as a, f is 1 for a0 and b0. It can be represented as a bar, b bar, and also it is 1 for a1, b0. We can represent it as a, b bar. Overall, it is 1 at 2 places, so we will add these two min terms. We can also see that f is equals to, this is min term 0, m0, this is min term 2, m2. So this is min term 0, this is min term 2, m2. So f is represented as summation, because sum of product form, summation, min term is represented by small m. Min term is represented by small m, so f is represented as summation m 0 comma 2 in this case. Now let us move to max term. Max terms are standard sum terms. Min terms were standard product sums, because product terms, because we can see a bar b bar c bar, it is a product. Whereas max terms are standard sum terms. These lead to POS, product of sum expressions, while min terms were leading to SOP, sum of product expression. These are represented by capital M of n, capital M of 0, capital M of 1, etc. If a is 0, then it is represented as a. If a is 1, it is represented as a bar in case of max terms, while in case of min terms, If a was 0, it was represented as a bar, and if a was 1, it was represented as a. And also dot will be replaced by plus. Let us see an example. Here a is 0, b is 0, so a would be represented as a, b would be represented as b, and previously we were writing as a bar dot b bar. Now we will write as a dot would be represented by plus a plus b. Similarly, a is 0, so a plus b is 1, b bar, a bar plus b, a bar plus b bar. And it is max term 0, 1, 2, 3, because its decimal equivalent is 0, its decimal equivalent is 3, its decimal equivalent is 2. Again, for n variables, total number of max terms would be 2 to the power n. Max terms leads to product of some expression. See, in minterms, to grab the expression from the truth table, we were deciding the function where the value was 1. But for max terms, for POS expression, remember, for POS expression, we will use the max terms where the function is 0. In this case, it is 0 here and 0. So it is max term 1, it is max term 3. Its representation would be f is equals to, product is represented as pi capital M of 1 and 3. So f would be represented as a, remember, a plus, because product of sum, a plus b bar dot a bar plus b bar. Okay, if you see, it is the same function as in case of minterms. The sum of product expression is this, and product of sum expression is this. If you will solve this expression, it will come as same as that of this expression. So this was all about minterms and max terms. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Please subscribe the channel and like the video. Thank you so much.